So our second mom that we're going to go ahead and honor this morning comes from the New Testament, and she's perhaps the greatest of them all, and it's Mary, the mother of Jesus. And God used Mary's story to really impact my life when I went with our youth group to a conference this summer in Austin, where Charlotte Gamble preached an amazing message about being chosen and how we can't just unchoose our callings or assignments from God. And you know, I'm a graduating senior, so my life has been full of choices this past season, and I know that there's going to be countless seasons in the future where I'm met with huge decisions once again. Who will I marry? Where will I live? What career or business opportunities will I pursue? And you know, for each of the choices that every one of us has to make in our lives, it's so important that we first understand that it's not about what we choose, it's about what chooses you. As the Message version states in John 15:16, "You didn't choose me. Remember, I chose you and put you in the world to bear fruit." And let's be real, when something chooses you, it can really mess up your plan sometime. Like, look at the life of Mary. She's just a young teenage girl, you know, living her life, loving God, planning to get married. And then one night, an angelic visitation changes literally everything. Her whole plan, her whole world turned upside down. She was chosen to be the mother of Jesus, who is coming to save the world. In Luke chapter 1, verses 26 through 25, it says, "Now in the sixth month, the angel Gabriel was sent from God to a city in Galilee named Nazareth, to a virgin betrothed to a man whose name was Jesus, of the descendants of David, and the virgin's name was Mary. And coming in, he said to her, 'Greetings, favored one, the Lord is with you.' And she was very perplexed at this statement and was pondering what kind of greeting this was." I would probably be doing the same thing. "And the angel said to her, 'Do not be afraid, Mary, for you have found favor with God. And behold, you will conceive in your womb and give birth to a son, and you shall name him Jesus. He will be great and will be called the Son of the Most High. And the Lord will give him the throne of his father David. And he will reign over the house of Jacob forever, and his kingdom will have no end.' But Mary said to the angel, 'How will this be, since I'm a virgin?' And the angel answered her and said, 'The Holy Spirit will come upon you, and the power of the Most High will overshadow you. For that reason, also the Holy Child will be called the Son of God.'" In verse 29, it said that Mary was very perplexed, or as another version says, very troubled. And I can see why, obviously, like, she's probably so confused at this moment. So she starts asking questions, and the angel's answer is that the power of the Most High God will overshadow you. And when God chooses you, you will be overshadowed. It's less of you, more of him. He's going to overshadow your plans and your dreams. Mary learned to surrender what she had planned in order for God's greater plan to unfold. And when something chooses you, it also changes you. I mean, literally, Mary's entire physical appearance started to change. Her clothes no longer fit. I'm sure it was exhausting. But not in our lives today, when we start to carry out our purpose and our calling, there's going to be certain things that no longer fit, whether it's friendships, conversations, even our media or entertainment. And Mary, she was also misunderstood, right? We know everyone in town probably gossiped and questioned this virgin birth about to happen. So God had to send her away to be with Elizabeth, who was then pregnant with John the Baptist. He gave her a friend who could relate. So God needs what chooses you to move you out of certain friendships, circles, to others who can relate and breathe life into what you're carrying. When Mary went to Elizabeth, we see a change in her from being perplexed in troubles to full of praise and rejoicing. Let's listen to her song in Luke chapter 1, verses 46 through 49. It says, "Mary responded, 'Oh, how my soul praises the Lord, how my spirit rejoices in God my Savior. For he took notice of his lowly servant girl, and from now on all generations will call me blessed. For the Mighty One is holy, and he has done great things for me.'" I just love that verse so much in that passage, because Mary's visit with Elizabeth truly shows the power of relationships and how the right voices and influences in our lives can truly shape us and encourage us in our calling. Another truth that Mary shows us is what chooses you doesn't belong to you. And I know as humans, this is kind of a hard pill to swallow, right? Like, when we think of all our life's accomplishments, we want our names attached to them. All the big moments, we want our face, our name, to be associated with it. But when you're chosen, it's not about making a name for yourself. Mary, Elizabeth, even Jochebed, They didn't even get to name what they were carrying, their babies. It was chosen for them. Mary's life of faith and obedience in her calling set the stage for the greatest story of all time to unfold, Jesus. God used a humble teenage girl to bring his son to earth, and nothing was ever the same. Our next question this morning is, what has God chosen you to do? We all have a purpose for which we were born, and nothing in this world is ever going to satisfy if you keep on running from that calling. So carrying Jesus was not her plan, yet Mary ultimately learned to trust God in his greater plan. She was obedient and faithful in what God entrusted her to carry.